Hey guys, it is time to wax. So, when do we wax, why do we wax, and what do we wax with, and how do we do it? So we wax for a couple of different reasons. One is to enhance the color and the texture and the overall look of the piece, the painted piece. When you add a wax, it can add a little bit of sheen, or it can add a little bit of a matte finish that is like a little bit of polish. Just kind of takes it from dry to, ooh. It just enhances, it brings out the color of the piece. And I like it when it adds a little tiny bit of sheen. Not too shiny, but a little bit. So there's different waxes that add various levels of sheen, and we'll talk about a couple of those. Also, wax, you can add colored wax when you want to add additional color and dimension to your piece. We're going to do that in a separate segment, okay? And lastly, we add wax when we want to give the piece an additional layer of protection. It acts as a very light durability sealer to seal in your paint. It's not for heavy duty applications. It does need to be reapplied every once in a while when your furniture starts showing some wear or lacking luster, then you can just reapply some wax whenever it needs it. But it's a beautiful, wonderful thing. So let's talk about the couple different waxes that I use. Of course, I use Dixie Belle's Best Dang Wax. Now these are clear waxes, okay guys? So this one goes on white, but it dries clear, okay? This one is, and this is sort of a classic cream wax. It's kind of thick. You have to work with it a little bit more, but the reward is a nice hard coat and a matte finish. This one has a matte, in other words, not shiny, no sheen finish. Then there's Daddy Van's Furniture Polish. This is their wax. This is clear also. It's almost gone. It goes on a little yellowy. This is 100% natural beeswax product. So you can see the yellow is, it's all natural. And this goes on very much like, just like melted butter. It's very emollient. So it's easier to work with and has a light sheen. So I tend to gravitate towards this one because it's easier to work with and it has that light sheen. But sometimes I really want what this one has to offer. So choose what's right for you, okay? So I talked about wax brushes in my earlier module. It can be this brand or not. It just has to, I don't say has to be a wax brush, but it is best if it's a wax brush because look at that tip. It holds so much product and it's very firm that you can really work that wax in, because unlike other top coats we're going to talk about later, when you're waxing, you really want to kind of work it into the paint. It kind of soaks in as opposed to just sits on top. So this is a great, just a wax brush is great. So I'll start with a little bit of the Dixie Belle wax, and I'll bring the camera in a little bit closer. So I'm going to swirl my brush in the wax, get some on, and then just brush it on to my piece. You'll see, again, it goes on white, but unless you're using white, it dries clear. So kind of work it in. You don't have to rub real hard or anything, but just, you know, make sure you don't miss any spots. That's kind of key. So one of the mistakes that a lot of new people make is not putting enough product on, not putting enough wax on the brush, and trying to stretch it out. Don't do that. Instead, put plenty on your brush and work it in, and then what we're going to do is wipe off the excess, okay? You want to work a section at a time so that the wax doesn't dry and your work project is manageable. So I'm going to take a clean dry towel and just wipe off the excess here. Now again, this particular brand of wax does not have really sheen to it. It may look a little bit shiny while it's wet, but it's pretty much a classic matte finish, which a lot of people like that on their chalk painted pieces. So it just depends on what you like. So I'm just wiping off the excess, moving on to over here. trying to get it out of these little grooves and such. Sometimes it helps to have a dry paintbrush handy just to get the wax out of the grooves when it gets a little bit stuck in there. Get it out of the details, okay? All right, so that's the Dixie Belle wax. It will dry and harden to provide a level of protection, a mild level of protection. And I'm just kind of wiping my brush off a little bit to show you the Daddy Vans. This is the Daddy Vans Furniture Polish. And this one's a little bit more emollient. I am down to the bottom of the container. It has a little bit of sheen to it. You can probably see that. Wipe off the excess. But keep in mind too that it's wet, right? So it's not necessarily going to dry this shiny. But I really like this wax. I like a little tiny bit of sheen on my project, and also it just is easy to work with. All right? So that's the Daddy Vans wax. So that's what you do, you guys. It's really easy. You just keep working it. Work it in. Wax on, wax off, like the Karate Kid, right? So put some on your brush. And this, you can go different directions. Right? You can go up and down and all around. It just doesn't really matter because your objective is to kind of work it in. Just don't try to stretch it out. If you don't have enough product on, load up your brushing can or just add a little bit more. Because when you wipe it, when you wipe it, that's when you're going to go one direction. Okay, so I'm wiping off the excess, one direction, pretty much. Now, sometimes there's a little bit of lint left on from the rag. If that happens, and it's most noticeable on dark pieces, just use like a t-shirt or a cut up cotton sheet. And that's what I usually end up doing, is just look for a little piece of a cut up t-shirt or cotton piece to kind of wipe the lint off before the wax dries too much. In other words, within, you know, a couple of hours. The wax, it dries quickly, but it continues to dry over the course of several weeks, and that's when it hardens and does what they call cures, becomes hard. Okay, so it'll still look a little bit wet, but you can still, you know, take a t-shirt or something if you've got a little bit of lint going in there. So you just keep doing that all over your piece. I'm gonna save the top for one of the other top coats and show you what I'm gonna do with that. So I'll just do a couple more minutes of this waxing here. I'll do this shelf. And you really need to get another jar of this delicious wax because I'm almost out. And since, like, you know, I did this side and Dixie Belle on this side and Daddy Vans just to demonstrate. But since I do want the same level of sheen on both sides, I'll slap a little Daddy Vans onto this just for that purpose. But you do not need two coats of wax ordinarily, okay? That's, you can, but it's not really necessary. So I'm going to come in on this side and just kind of get the back of this here. Some people hate to wax, and you know, it's not the funnest part, but if you're using a good wax that you enjoy working with, it's not bad. And you'll really appreciate how it transforms your piece by really enhancing the color of the paint and giving it just sort of a finished look that you otherwise don't get if you don't give it a top coat of some kind. Oh, nice chunk. Gotta get a new can. So Yeah, for me, it just like it really enhances and finishes the look of the piece. So do about that much, and then where my rag go? Wipe off the excess. Okay, now that's gonna take. It'll dry to the touch soon. It's like you can touch it and pick up the piece and move it, and nothing's gonna happen. You're not gonna get fingerprints on. Because what you could do later is just kind of wipe it off. So when it dries, it's nice to buff it out. Some waxes require it, some brands, and some don't. So when I say buff it out, there are different ways you can buff it out. You can take a clean, dry towel after it's dry, like after a couple days, and then just buff it out by hand, but that's kind of labor intensive. But it just kind of sets the wax and enhances the polish look. Or you can use a buffer like this. This is sold in auto shop stores or hardware stores, pretty cheap. This is what they call a bonnet, it's dirty. And then you, super duper 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 easy. And then the wax will continue to cure and harden over the course of a few weeks. You can use the piece of furniture, but I would avoid putting anything really on it until the wax has dried at least a week. All right, you guys, that is your clear wax module.